Hi everyone, I'm Mrs. Charles, back with another I Spy Science and Wired for Science activity. You're going to really love this project because it's lots of fun. We're making a worm farm. And it could be a really messy project, so you might want to do it outside. This is what you need to make a worm farm. You need a plastic bucket, and my bucket is not clear. That way the worms will feel nice and cozy. But if you use a clear container, you can take a piece of black paper and cover both the lid and the sides. You also need permanent markers if you want to decorate your container, a large spoon, black and white newspaper. We don't want to use colored. A spray bottle with water. Gardening soil. I use topsoil rather than stuff you use for plants. This topsoil is better. You need worms, and then of course you need fruit and veggie, peels and scraps. So the first step to making your worm farm is decorating your bucket. You can use your own markers and decorate your bucket any way you'd like. I'm just going to do simple flower, maybe put a stem. Color it in. And then I think I'll make a worm. Okay, so you get the idea. You can decorate around the sides and along the top, however you'd like. Now the next thing you do is take a piece of newspaper and you're going to shred it. So I'm gonna go like this. And just make strips, and you can do this pretty much any way you'd like. So I take my strips, and then I'm going to make them smaller, into smaller pieces. Ugh, it's too hard, I have to open them up. That looks like enough. Then I'm going to spray it with water. Okay, now you're going to add the newspaper to the dirt. You'll first put dirt in the bucket, and then you'll add your newspaper, and it'll be messy, but you just mix the newspaper in with the dirt. And if it looks like you need a little more dirt or newspaper, you can always cut more. And it's a mess. That's kind of fun. Kind of want to get the newspaper to go down to the bottom. Okay, that looks good. Okay, now you're going to add your worms. It's really important that you treat the worms gently. You don't want to injure them. They're living and they must be treated respectfully. So I'm going to pour them out of my cup. And you can see they come with a little dirt. And this is what they look like. Some of them are smaller and some of them are bigger, but they're alive. And you just put them in the dirt. And I think I'm going to mix the dirt a little so that they're slightly covered, and then they'll find where they want to go. Okay, it's very important that you make sure you feed your worms daily or at least every other day. Save your fruit and veggies, peels and scraps to give to them. And don't overdo it because you don't want the food to rot. One worm can eat half its weight in a few days. You do not want to put any kind of meat scraps. That's not good for them. So make sure there's no meat. So I've got some lettuce here. I'll just put some in the top. And you can put whatever food scraps you have. They would like red peppers or broccoli and cabbage, anything you can think of that you would not eat yourself and you don't want to put it in the garbage. Okay, now you need to use a large spoon to turn the dirt over several times a week. This will help add some air and oxygen to your worm farm, which the worms need. In time, the worms will turn the scraps of food and paper into rich soil, perfect for your garden. Okay, now you're going to cover your bucket. You could actually have your mom or dad help you poke a few air holes in the top, but make sure they're very tiny so that the worms don't escape. Okay, so why would you want to make a worm farm? Well, there are a couple of reasons why it's good to make a worm farm. It's a good way to recycle fruit and veggie scraps instead of putting them into the garbage and then a landfill. And the worms will eat the scraps and then poop into the dirt, making the soil full of good nutrients. Then you can add this good soil to your flower or your vegetable garden. It's like adding fertilizer, and the worms aerate the soil. If you don't have a garden, you can use the worms on a family fishing trip. I hope you have a really great time making your own worm farm. Make sure you take good care of your worms.